There's no way I'll get past that huge lock. There's nothing for me over there. Okay. By the way, past the lock, but there's nothing over for me over there. And there I was, standing in the rain. There was something in that moment, as if I would have felt her presence. It's hard to describe. I know you don't blame me for anything, but I'm sorry. From the little I got to know you, you deserve better. Your passing was a wake-up call for me. I've decided to quit. Wherever you may be, I hope you're okay. I'm sure you are. Oh, before I forget, I brought you something. It's not much, but... may it light your path in the afterlife. Rest in peace, Mrs. Goodwin. I mustered up the courage. It would end now. I couldn't live like this. And so I went to see my bosses. I went to resign. No, I'm here to quit. I'm not gonna chicken out. It's a water machine. There's still some water in it. Oh, wait. The office, no. Hey, Jenny, how goes it? Nice to see you, Mr. Price. Have you seen the big guys? No. I don't know where they are. Stop interrogating me. Calm down, Jenny. Sheesh. Sorry. Any messages for me? No, I'm afraid not. Okay, well, let me know if you find out where the bosses are. Sure thing, Mr. Price. I wonder what that was all about. The office, coffee room. Huh, it's open. Salt shaker. Okay, what am I supposed to do with this? If I put the salt in the safe now, maybe in a few million years it'll eat through the iron. It's shut tight. Empty. I don't want to drink coffee now. A little salt for the flavor? Done. I guess we did that for a reason. It's too salty. Okay, we rigged their coffee? To get revenge at them or something? Bathroom. I'm tempted, but I don't like public toilets. That's right, his bladder can hold out for like 2 days, apparently. Okay, says Bruton. McDade. Price. Hey! Don't touch my phone, okay? Sorry. That's your phone there? Hey, what are you doing? Installing a nameplate for you, Mr. Price. Huh. And more. Nothing interesting here. Alright. I don't know which one we want to specifically talk to first. Bruton? I talked to Bruton on the phone. Doesn't look like he's here. It's not ringing. McDade? Finally, more. That's not ringing. No inventory, right? I put salt in the coffee. Now what? Hey Jenny, there's something wrong with the coffee. What's that? Tastes funny. Salty even. I'm tired of these pranks. Fine, fine. I'll take a look. Thank you, Jenny. And once she's gone, we get to investigate. Okay, what's this? I think this is what Jenny connects the phone calls with. I'll insert the cord into the blue plug. Done. Okay, what now? I can't do anything else? Insert the cord into the... Do I want to go back upstairs and mess with their phones? Is that what? Oh! Now I'm Bruton? Speaking. Mr. Taylor is waiting on the line. Can I connect the call? What? Again? Ark. Please do. Okay, how is this even logically, like, making any sense here? Bruton. Hello, Bruton. This is Taylor speaking. How do you do, Mr. Taylor? Listen, I understand the city is going to build a highway. I've come to accept that. What? You have? Yeah, but I think it would be only fair if my cavern was moved elsewhere. I mean, you only need my site, not my actual home. I can make the arrangement. Stop it! It's too late and too expensive for any of that. I can pay some of the expense. Not going to happen. I will send our new kid over there tomorrow. He'll make sure you sign the papers. But goodbye now, Mr. Taylor. What a... Beep. Huh. I never realized he was so crude. So we're playing back phone conversations from the past by patching in that blue cord or something. No idea. Oh! Don't do that. Not ringing. Do I need to do it over and over again? I need to trick her away. That's yellow. White? I don't know. Brown? Because she plugged it into a blue... I put it into a blue plug or something, I said. Oh, it was blue. Not anymore. But this last one here, more, is... does have a color to it. It's a lot more yellow, isn't it? So maybe he needs to put it into a yellow plug now? I mean, he did the blue automatically. She's back, though. Have you seen the bosses now? No! I don't know where they are! Okay. Now this safe is open. There's something... a mug. Hey, it's my coffee mug! No. No. I bet it's not salty anymore. It's hard to say no for the coffee, but maybe later. So they have a safe with salt and a safe with a mug. It's a water machine. Still some water? Okay. Maybe we'll put that in the mug. Don't mind if I do. Maybe one more glass. Or a mug. Water is healthy. A little more. Must drink more. Time to use the bathroom? I'm gonna burst! Whoops! I think I drank it all. Mug removed. It's empty and I'm still thirsty. But our mug is gone. So now we tell her to fill the water machine. And we get to do our thing again. Hey Jenny, I'm sorry to bother you again. What is it this time? There's no water in the water machine. And I'm thirsty. What? How? I just changed the bottle today. I don't know. Okay, okay. I'm going. Yes. Okay, the cord is currently in the blue plug. I'll insert it into the red plug. Done. She's doing her thing. Okay. I'm not sure. I don't check my date. Oh god. Gotta do that every time. Yeah? Mr. Jones is waiting on the line. Alright, connect him. This is McDade speaking. Hey man, this is J-Bomb. I haven't found a new apartment yet. Could you postpone the expropriation? Just a few weeks so I can find somewhere to stay? Anything else? Do you want me to look for you? Do you want me to hold your hand and walk you across the street? Stop calling here. I'll send someone there tomorrow to take care of things. So the person they're talking about they're sending is Price, always, the character we're playing. But dude, I really... farewell. Ha. Funny guy. I wasn't really fond of the guy either. But that was just unnecessarily cruel. Okay. So last one thing we have to check is more. I thought this was going to be the next one, but... this one's very yellow. Alright, so I guess now we're going down and opening the third safe. Seeing what's in there that we can use to screw with things. I do like this part. It's entertaining. Did she fill it again? Still no water. I thought Jenny would change the bottle. Really, Jenny, what the hell? I bet you know where the bosses are. No. You're wrong. Okay. I don't know why she didn't change it. Here's the third safe. Let's see. It's a rag. The safe could really use some polishing, but that's not what I'm here for. It's not dusty and thus requires zero cleaning. What are we gonna do with a rag? Stuff it in something and make something break? Flush it down the toilet and stop up the toilet. Hopefully this won't clog the toilet. Hopefully it will. Whoops. He knows what he's doing. I can't use it now. It's out of order. He knows exactly what he's doing. Jenny, the toilet is clogged. Could you go and take a look, please? What am I, a plumber? You know we hired a janitor a little while back? I'll just call him. No, no, don't do it. I was gonna talk to him anyway. So I might as well tell him about the toilet. That's nice of you. We're right here. Twist ending, he figures out what game save means. Hi. Isn't this the janitor? Thought it was. Oh, whoa! What is that thing? Turn the phone off. It's already off. I turned his phone off. I go back to her now and tell her to call him. I couldn't find him. Can you please call him? He doesn't answer, so then she goes looking for him. No, I have not played this before. So I thought I saw the janitor earlier, but now I can't find him anywhere. Maybe we should call him after all? Okay, one second. The number cannot be connected. Figured it'd go straight to voicemail. I think his phone is shut off. What a bummer. We really need to get that toilet working again. Okay, I'll go. Thank you, Jenny. You're awesome. I know. I know, she says. From red to green plug. All set. Okay. Now for more. Ready for a loud sound. Yep. What's up, Jenny? Mrs. Goodwin is waiting on the line. Should I connect her? Please do. Moore. Hi, Mr. Moore. This is Goodwin. How do you do, Mrs. Goodwin? Not too well, to be honest. My pension isn't too much, and all the meds are awfully expensive. Maybe you should have worked harder, or eat healthier. Your debt is only your own doing. That's not fair, Mr. Moore. You know my husband passed away, and all the bureaucracy and confusing laws. Well, I just don't think it's fair. that I need to pay the inheritance tax. Well, you should have done the proper paperwork. There are laws and you must honor them. I suppose, Mr. Moore. I suppose. Well, the reason I'm calling is I'm asking you for a little more time. I've been arranging my things and... No! The law does not compromise. There's nothing I can do. Surely there... Goodbye. What an old hag. What's that? Go and show them, dear. The moment of truth, son. Where am I going? All of a sudden we're moving faster. Oops. I entered through the door. It was as black as night and as quiet as a grave. Only the pulse of my heart broke the silence. One more step. And the lights came alive with a shout. Surprise! The band started playing. Balloons floated to the ceiling. They were all there. My bosses, Jenny, and my colleagues. It took a moment for me to figure out what was going on. Were they having a celebration, like, that he's joining the company? I had proved myself. The party was for me, for my partnership. I took a long breath and swallowed. I prepared myself to shout my resignation out loud. That's, like, gotta be the worst time to do it. But then something happened. A purple silky cloth revealed its secret. What? A new sign with my name on it. Greed reared its ugly head, and my backbone snapped like a dry stick. But did you get your partnership? What happened next? Yeah, I got my partnership. Well, I suppressed my feelings, my guilt. I kept working for a few years. You sure you don't want a swig? No thanks, sir. I'm on duty. On duty? Hope you don't mind if I do? Not at all, sir. Who is this? I lied to myself. It's all okay, I said to myself. I just kept blowing into the balloon, you know? It only stretches so far. My mind broke. I started slipping. Heck, it may even have been deliberate. Not long after that, I was fired. And the standard of living I was used to, I went into debt. Big time. I lost everything. She's gonna take his home. She's here to seize his home. I feel pretty horrible for taking over your property now. Listen, kid. The reason I told you my story... Please say no more, sir. You really remind me of when I was a younger... I'll admit, your story really puzzles me. I will give my career a second thought for sure. This probably was the first good deed I've done in my whole life. Please think it through so you won't end like I did. Well, visiting... The old lady in a nursing home was a good thing. Visiting her in the cemetery was a good thing, but I guess it wasn't good enough. I will, but... Oh gosh, I hate doing this. You'll have to move out by the end of this month. I know the drill, kid. Take care now. I really hope he listened to my story. I thought that was a female. I think this is it. The bottle is empty. No more whiskey for me. It's not a gas oven. I can't kill myself with it. We're gonna kill ourselves now? Is that what's going on? I don't want to. I'll end my ambitious life in this humble chair. I spent my last coin to buy this shotgun. I guess it's time to use it. Don't use it. There must be a better way to end your life. Depressing. To write a suicide note. What do I have to say? What comes around, goes around. Screw it. That'll have to do. I wrote a suicide note. Oh my god, it's funny, but it's not funny. Nothing interesting here. My first note is perfectly fine. I don't want to have him kill himself. I'll just keep this note to myself. I have a note written. I need something to finish the deed. Really? The only choice is to sit in that chair and use a shotgun. Good God. Come on, just make yourself a cup of coffee instead. Toilet paper is the only kind of paper that goes down a toilet. I best not. That could ease some of my depression. Nah. No, I will need this shotgun to end my days. Best not. Okay, then. Fine. There's nothing else to do. Okay. Is this heaven? There's like moss or butterflies going around the light there. I feel bad for him. Oh, this is the one leaving the house that I thought was a female. I hope he will be fine. It's not gonna be fine. Come on, elevator. Just want to get away from here. All of a sudden, blam. Right, so depressing as hell. What do you guys think? Crazy. I really enjoyed it. Hope you guys enjoyed watching me play along. Oh, we're not over yet. Thank you for playing Distraint Deluxe Edition. It took quite a few cups of coffee to make this game. Oh, and only the credits only roll as I have her go in a wheelchair. I had a lot of fun, though, and as of writing this in 2017, the sequel is in the works. That's right. Distraint 2 is coming. Yeah, guys, let me know if you're interested in watching me play Distraint 2. If you enjoyed this, you can play some more. It's only a few bucks on GOG or Steam. I prefer GOG, actually, for this. I'd like to thank my wife Jenny, or the receptionist, for her support, and my kids Reiko and Minja. Also, thanks to my brother Jiso for doing Q&A. I also got to work with some amazing people that volunteered to translate the game. Thanks to them, this game is now available in quite a few languages. Speaking of, the subtitles you used, Carl Quigley, check out his WordPress. Proofreading, Jack Longman. You can find me on these social media sites. That will be all. Thank you. Our husband. Yay. Okay, so not so sad an ending, after all. The end. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope to see you guys in another Let's Play. Let me know if you're interested in me playing Distraint 2. Leave your comments below. Thanks so much for watching, and always seek adventure.